sirve. This Sunday is the last Sunday of the Epiphany. It kind of caps off and ends the joyful season of Christmas and Epiphany tide and gets us ready to slide into Lent. If you come Tuesday night, we are having pancakes and bacon, as all Episcopal churches do pretty much for Shrove Tuesday. And I'll put a shameless plug in that the money you donate that night will support the mission trip this summer. So be generous, right? But then, right after Shrove Tuesday, guess what day comes? Ash Wednesday. And guess what Ash Wednesday is all about? No, it's not about Valentine's Day at all. Not even a little bit about Valentine's Day. I mean, think, what do we call it? But yes, but it's called Ash Wednesday. The ashes are kind of an important bit. You will show up having your tummies filled with pancakes and sausage and bacon, and you will get a big smudgy cross in ash on your forehead. And I'll say to you, remember that you are dust. To dust you shall return. In the Episcopal Church, we love the ash of Ash Wednesday so much that some people even run around all over the world on street corners and subways and taxi cab stands, smudging people's foreheads with ashes. And then comes Lent. And many of you, I bet, you don't have to raise your hands lest you fall into the sin of pride. But many of you have probably thought about, what am I getting up for Lent this year? Right? And you name it, I've seen someone give it up. From swearing, to smoking, or drinking, or fried food, or meat. Lots of stuff to give up for Lent. Some of you have probably thought about, I'm going to take on something for Lent, right? Maybe being a bit healthier, more mindful, something. But what if Ash Wednesday wasn't really about the ashes after all? And what if Lent isn't really about penance, or isn't really about giving up something, not having chocolates, or taking something off? What if instead it's about transformation? Every last Sunday after the Epiphany, every year for this Sunday, you get the reading of the Transfiguration. Deacon Margaret just read it to you. And what happens in that story every year? Jesus goes out to the wilderness, takes a couple of disciples with him, and where do they go? Up the mountain. And then they get to the top of the mountain, and what happens? Right, dazzling white, Jesus is there, very bright, they shield their eyes, they become a little bit afraid. They worship. For the first time, they see the transfigured Jesus. Literally, metamorpho in Greek, like metamorphosis. The changed Jesus. They see Jesus like he really is, as Lord and King and God. And then they go down the mountain. Jesus tells them not to tell anyone just yet. Every year you get that story. But maybe we get that story this Sunday because we need to be ready for transformation. For our own metamorphosis, our own changing. Ash Wednesday, even if you don't get any ashes on you at all, is still a good day. Because the ashes don't really matter. What matters is the transformation in your heart. What matters is is that you start to take some steps to change the way you live to become a saint. And for Lent, does it really matter very much if you take up chocolate or give it up for Lent? I mean, if you're a type 2 diabetic, don't take up chocolate for Lent, right? Hear me there. But for most of us, a little bit of chocolate, one way or the other, is not a huge deal. And Lent, the purpose isn't to give up something or to take something on. The whole point of Lent is that you and your life might be transformed to be a little bit more like Jesus. You might become a little bit more like a saint in these 40 days. And so, as you get ready for Ash Wednesday, turn up at 7 a.m. or 6 p.m. that day. You'll get your smudgy ashes, don't worry. But ask yourself three questions. What do I need to take out of my life if I'm going to become a saint? What in my life is keeping me from being like Jesus? Two, what should I have more of in my life if I'm going to become a saint? If I'm going to be like Jesus, what do I need more of? Three, am I willing to make changes to the way I live to become a saint? Am I willing to change what I do to be more like Jesus? Amen. My brothers, my sisters, please stand with me as we confess our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed.